face that's on the underside. So we'll get that face down there, and then we'll get this face here and hit the green check mark, and boom, Onshape was able to completely clean up that inside. And that is a mug. I think that what I would do with this is I would probably go to the mug now and say adjust appearance and maybe make it like the Onshape green color. There we go.
Hey,
what do you think about that, Mike?
That looks fantastic.
That is a mug right there.
That is a mug.
Wow.
Now, I've been doing some stuff while you've been working as well. And instead of like doing it while you were in the same workspace, I was doing it asynchronously.
Okay.
All right. So
tell
I was
me more.
Using what Eduardo was mentioning earlier, which was the branching, right? So go to the version tree.
Okay.
Yeah. And you'll see another branch here. I needed to design a knob. And I needed to make some other modifications, right?
This is pretty cool. So yeah. You branched off here. Okay.
You branched off there. And you can click in the show changes. And you can see, you know, all the different things going on.
Okay.
Another thing you can do is compare what you have on your screen with
what does this mean, though? I mean, it looks the same on screen.
Well, we haven't gone into the knob, so you're still on the main branch, and okay. I am on the knob. So if you clicked on the knob right there, that would bring you to that branch, and you'd
see
that I am in that branch, and I've done some things as well.
Okay.
I also have, like, drawings and imported parts and stuff, but I branched after you added the photo. Like, that was when I branched.
Okay.
And anything you did after that isn't showing on mine because you were on the main branch and I was on the knob branch, right? So
this could be like if you thought you might have a good idea, but you don't necessarily want to like mess up the original.
Yeah.
You could do a branch here, and then how would you get it back into the main one if it turns out it was a good idea? First of all, what did you do with this version?
Yeah, let's figure out what we did first. Okay. And you can compare. So if you click the compare button,
okay,
they're going to compare knob against main. So you click knob and click main.
Just right here.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh.
Right, so it's showing us differences. Now at the top, you see B1 knob and main, and you see that little slider menu. Drag that slider.
Oh, wow.
So I can see you've added the handle.
Okay. Yep.
You're not going to see the knob. You can see I have a hole for a knob in the top. That's showing in red, right? And you can see the feature list is actually showing us, like, you know, the actual diff of the features.
So it's like add, remove.
The slider is showing you the graphical method of seeing it. I even added configurations to this.
Okay.
You see how this configurations there? Tall, extra tall, too tall, right?
Yes. Okay.
I can actually compare configured sizes.
Oh, this is so cool. This makes it so easy to tell what the difference is.
Yeah. So, yes. And you can click on each one of those things in that list, too, and it would highlight, cross-highlight and everything, too.
See, this is my kind of coffee mug right here, the two-tall version.
That's it.
Yeah. And you can click on the features here, too. Okay.
Yeah, so you get the deep details there. Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
But
very cool.
But now that we have these both on the screen, let's say we want to unite everything I did in the knob with the main. You go back to main.
Go back to over here?
Yeah, go back to main.
Yep.
Now right-click on the knob and say merge in the current workspace, because main is the current workspace. And it will give you a diff report. Merge strategy screen, right?
Okay, yep.
Now it's showing you there's some other tabs that were added. I added a drawing for the lid. I went to McMaster Car and I downloaded a knob and I made an assembly.
Okay.
A knob in the assembly, and you can see I downloaded a SolidWorks part for the knob, and I can see, you know, you've uploaded the photo to the document. And this is showing us we can merge changes in the mug and the part studio. Yeah. So you just go ahead and merge it. I think it'll
Let's go.
If it doesn't
too
work.
Too tall, baby.
All right. Yeah, there we are.
There's the tall. There.
Tall.
And there's the too tall.
Too tall.
Oh, yeah. See, that's the kind of coffee mug I need right there. I need that extra, like, half a cup. Because I feel like I always drink the first cup, and then I'm like, I need a little more, but I don't know if I want a full cup. And, yeah.
It was pretty easy to add the configuration.